if a reader's struggling and their mind is trying to catch and stay entrained in the cognitive processing that's associated and necessary with reading this code, and their frustration with it and their confusion with it leads to the emergence of them feeling ashamed of themselves or feeling bad about themselves, feeling anything. Their consciousness is splitting. What they're processing is no longer the self-transparent code work. It's now involves themselves in
a way. Right.
The moment that it starts to involve themselves, it's draining the brain capacity to work the code.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So that this leads to a kind of a downward spiral. The more that they become self-conscious in the reading, the harder the reading.
Absolutely.
The harder the reading, the more self-conscious. And boom.
Absolutely.
Okay, so you've got a particular language for describing
That space? Well, you've described it very nicely, I think. I mean, basically, it's a very maladaptive feedback cycle that you approach a task with anxiety because of concerns about your own performance. That distracts from your attention, your ability to focus on and process the information that's being provided, which impairs your performance more, which increases your anxiety, and this cycle continues to amplify itself. And I think that is, what becomes then inappropriate behavior, intentional tuning out, doing anything that you can so that you give the appearance that either I don't care about this or this isn't an important activity. Don't try to tell me this is important. I know it's not important because I'm not doing well at it, and I'm never going to do well at it. And if I acknowledge its importance, I would just have to sit here and be sad. Now, we don't work that way as human beings. We don't acknowledge these sorts of things. We have all these wonderful defenses that we put into play, which unfortunately many times don't serve us very well. But we can see those at work all of the time.